गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड इवनिंग। अप टू द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द नेटवर्क, इट्स टाइप्स, इट्स टोपोलॉजी, देन लैन, वैन, मैन, एम टोपोलॉजी इज देयर। नाउ I am going to move towards the subject, that is peer-to-peer network and the client-server network. Also, I explain peer-to-peer network and client-server network in short in the last lecture. Today, I am going to explain the two points in short and another 2-3 point with the different shade between client server and peer to peer network. So as I explained in the last lecture, peer to peer networks connected with each other, more than two nodes are connected to each other, is called peer to peer network. What is the criteria of peer to peer network? Where 10 or fewer users will be sharing resources, then nobody has the time or knowledge to act as network administrator. In that way, there are several computers attached with each other, that is peer-to-peer. Some advantages of peer-to-peer network is what? They are easy to configure, computers communicate easily, they don't require additional server, user can manage their own resources, and it reduces the total cost. Some disadvantages is over there, such as it provide the limited number of connections. Definitely, if there are several computers, so we can't connect each computer to each other. Rather, it is very difficult task to connect to each other. Then computers with shared resources suffer from sluggish performance. Might be some computers are not working properly. In that case, its performance is going to be very sluggish. They don't allow for central management. Peer-to-peer network don't allow the central management. Due to that, it is very difficult to find out what works we want, we require, and which computer that works fulfill. So it is a hectic task. Users are responsible for managing the resources. These resources include the data shares in directories, printers, fax cards, and so on. Definitely, users are responsible for managing the resources. So each and every component, rather each and every node's computers must have to install all the resources, what user want, what the user's requirement. If suppose user want to take the printout, so from which peer user want to take the printouts, that peer must be installed the required resources. So this is some disadvantages of peer-to-peer network. Then client-server network is what? It is the central server system where one device is there and the number of computers attached with that device, such as our lab. In our computer lab, there one computer, one device, and all the computers are attached with that device. That is client-server network. This is a network model that offers the centralized access to services and devices. One computer plays the role of a server. In that system, one computer plays a role of server, and it is most common type of the network architecture today. Definitely, the client server in the client server system is the most common type of network in today's era. Some disadvantages of client server and advantages of client server is what? Advantages is we can use more computers, security is there, administration is very good across the client-server system, stability, centralized backup, definitely flexibility and accessibility. In short, client-server network is more reliable, more secure. We can administer very easily. Stability, then flexibility and accessibility is the advantages of the client-server system. On the other hand, some disadvantages of client-server system is there. That is, due to it is centralized distributed system, sometimes the device is going to be fail, all the system is been collapse. This is the main disadvantages of this system. Another disadvantages that is most commonly disadvantage, that is, it is very expensive and dependence. Where server goes down, operations will increase across the network definitely. Now there are several servers, and that servers provide the data to the client. Rather, we can say a number of supporting tools provide the client. So there are several servers. The first server is the file server. File servers are used to store the user documents and files centrally. An ideal file server should have a large amount of memory and storage space, fast hard disk and multiple processors for network adapters, redundant power supplies, etc. A file server runs FTP, that is File Transfer Protocol, in Windows, Linux or Unix networks, or SMBP, that is Server Message Block Protocol, in Windows. The main advantages of keeping network user file and electronic documents centrally in the file server is that the network user files and documents can be managed easily. See, what is the use of, rather, what is a file server? File server is that type of server from where the clients can get the files. Rather, there are a lot of number of files stored, and through the FTP, that is File Transfer Protocol, in Windows and into the Linux and Unix networks, SMBP, that is Server Message Block Protocol, supports to transfer the file, to ship the file from server to clients. And what is the main advantage? The main advantage is, due to the files are stored electronically in the server, it is very easy to manage and take the backup. So this is the file server. Then print server is what? As you know, in our lab there are several computers attached with the hub switch, and when we give any print to the computers from any place, computers configured in the network, that is print server. There are several computers, and from any computer we get the print. So this is the print server. What is the mail server? It is also like a file server. Mail server are used to transmit the emails using the email protocol. Most widely used email transmission protocol is the SMTP, that is Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. What is SMTP? Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, which is used to transfer the mail from any computer to any other computer, that is the mail server. When we going to send any mail to our friend, automatically mail server to be activate, and the SMTP works to transfer, to exchange the emails between the different domains. Most widely used of mail server software product are Microsoft Exchange Server, that is SendMail, Gmail, Postfix, etc. Then the application server. Common computer applications are programs which are required by different network. User can be run in a central server, which enables multiple network users to access the common network application from the network. See, what is the application server? When we are using the computer, there are several softwares is there. So some softwares in one business is frequently used on different machines. So the application servers provide that facility. We can use that software simultaneously on the multiple computers, that is through the application servers. In the database servers, same thing. In the one computer of the college system, there the database server, the database is situated in that computer, and 2, 3, 4 windows are using that database through the network, that is the database server. So this is the types of server, that is file server, print server, mail server, application server and database server. Directory servers also is there that support central administration and management of networks. One directory, one file, one information can we can fetch any computer in the networking system, that is the directory server. Now the difference between the client server and the peer-to-peer server. What is the basic of client server and peer-to-peer? That is, there are specific server and specific clients connected to the server in the client server. And into the peer-to-peer, client and server are not distinguished. Each node act as a client and server, definitely. Directly contact with each other, that is peer-to-peer, and the client specified and server specified into the client server. So that's why the basic between client server and peer-to-peer, there are a specific server and specific client, and into the peer-to-peer, node distinguished, each node act as a client and server. Then service, the client request for service and server respond to the service. Each node can request to the service and also provide the services. Definitely. Where the peer-to-peer network, two nodes are connected with each other and they respond to vice versa, and into the client server, the client request for the service and server can provide the service, rather respond with the service. Focused data, sharing the information, the data is stored into the centralized server. Definitely, in the client server system, the information stored in the server system, centralized server system, and when the client want that data, client demand, rather instruct to get the data and server provide that data into the peer-to-peer system. More than two nodes are connected to each other and they can pass the data equally to each other. Into the server, when several clients request for the services autonomously, a server can get the bottlenecked. On the other hand, when server client request for the services simultaneously, a server can get the bottlenecked. Server send the data client at the same time, and into the peer-to-peer system, as the services are provided by several servers distributed to peer-to-peer system, a server is not bottleneck. Server into the peer-to-peer system, there is no server, and due to that, the same time two or more nodes, rather peers, can transfer the data to each other. But in the server client system, the server send the data autonomously at the same time to the all systems, rather all clients, and the expenses, the client server are expensive and the peer-to-peer system are less expensive to implement. So here our first unit is going to be in. Thank you so much.